Right, so the start of this video, just recap, put some random stuff on the background, but it's basically just a quick update on what happened after I last went to the track. So a couple of things have happened. I was noticing a lot of understeer on the track on the day, so got some new springs, changed the shock setup quite a bit, thicker springs, thicker oils, also thickened up the oil in the diff. I fixed the camber in the front and the rear. Front is set to -2, I believe, or -1. And then in the rear, it's -1.5 camber. And then toe in the rear, I also straightened out to almost zero. Can't quite get it to zero with my car. And then the toe in the front, it's been left the same. But yeah, as you might see in this first clip, there is a new fan that I've got installed. This fan is to replace my old one, because my old one got broken when I went to the track because of the way it was positioned, and it got hit by another car and shattered and cut its own wire. So I've got a new fan which is taking its place and it's doing great. After just briefly driving my car around the house a little bit to see how it feels, it does feel a lot more responsive than it did when I went to the track. Hopefully tomorrow I'll be driving better than I was in the clip you're probably watching now. And I'm just going to leave this clip on to finish. No cuts, because I cut it a bit in the last video. Just watch some uncut footage and then I'll get into the content in this video. Ever since the wound till I'm back where my brother went, that's what my tumor say. Right up on my government tumor lay, either unmarked or engraved, hey, who's to say? Doomsday, ever since the wound till I'm back to the essence, read it off the tomb, either engraved or unmarked grave, who's to say? Pass the mic like pass the peas like they used to say. Some MFers don't like how Sally walk. I tell y'all fools is hella cool, her ladies from Cali talk. Never let it interfere with the Yeti ghetto slang. Nicknames off nipple and tip of nipples metal fang. Known amongst hoes for the bang bang. Known amongst foes for flow without no talking orangutans. Only gin and tang, guzzle out a rusty tin can. Me and this mic is like yin and yang. Clang, crime don't pay. Listen, you, it's like me holding up the line at the kissing booth. I took her back to the truck, she was uncool. Spitting all out the sunroof. So unfortunately, at this point, I hadn't actually got any footage, but I'd done my two practice rounds, and I believe at this point I'd done one qualifier round or two, not fully sure, but I just changed the tyres on my car, and you'll see now that my old tyres were completely stripped. They were destroyed, had barely any steering, so someone was kind enough to lend me some brand new front tyres. I was running them for the rest of the day and they felt so much better with so much more steering. Now we can go into the footage of the race, talk over it, and then at the end of the video I'll go over my setup changes and what else I think I can do to improve the car. Alright, so while lining up, I'm just going to mention, yes, I was in the I-final, that is the bottom group, but considering I've barely ever raced on carpet, I enjoyed myself. Doesn't really bother me that I wasn't in the top groups or anything, and it was good fun. There will also be quite a bit of commentating from my dad throughout the video, so enjoy him bullying me. But yeah, it felt a bit strange throughout the race, which I'll talk about. Car felt a bit too jittery, which I will go over an idea to fix that after we see the race footage. So I'm just going to cut ahead here where we skip the lining up because it's already been on for quite a while. And then we're going to get straight into the footage. Right, we're off. So, bit of a rough start, hit some people, but this is what really made me annoyed. got smacked into that side wall, got flipped over, well, not flipped over, but turned around right off the start and made me drop a place or two. So as you can see, the car is very responsive. I needed to smooth out the steering a lot, because as I said, with those new tyres, I had so much more steering. But at this point, I think I'm in fourth, but there, once again, cutting corners, and even my dad laughing at me for it. Not sure I went here, took a bit longer and missed that jump. I messed up that jump so many times in the day. You come around the corner, get to this massive jump, and it's quite hard to have time to line up your car properly. So as of right now, I'm just trying to make it round, catch up a bit. Yeah, there again, I cut the corner, as my dad mentioned once again. And yeah. That was unfortunate. Miscommunication with the marshals there, but it's alright.
Valuable time on your ass then.
Being bullied by my dad, of course.
Oh, he didn't cut the corner for a change.
There you go.
Oh, what's he doing?
It's unfortunate. I noticed the later I got into the race, the more I kept messing things up, which you'll see in the last lap I did. Yeah. I always found this carpet had so much grip because it's brand new carpet. I couldn't tell you what type, but honestly, the second you put power down or the second you put the brakes on, you stop so suddenly. I probably should have turned down the braking in the day, but I got around okay in the end. That was a nice turn. At this point, I was really just trying to push my car, really get back up to those people that are in front, because I believe I'm in fifth at this point.
There he is again.
They started in fourth. Bad mistake there. Was not happy with that. Luckily, someone got straight to my car, and I got to continue. As I said, problems with the jump again. This was also very annoying.
You love that ramp, eh?
Getting a bit more jittery nerves, obviously it being the final. Yeah, I just really wanted to keep going as fast as I could, get away from those that were close to me, because I just wanted smooth sailing up until I got close to the front. Quite unfortunate. I think, actually, this is when I went from 4th to 5th. This was unfortunate as well. Crashed mid-air with someone, ended up in the wall.
Oh, it's a fight again with that black one.
Yeah. Quite a few unfortunate moments like that where I tried to be a bit more aggressive, and considering I haven't been driving too long, I'd mess it up and just get into a collision and flip my car or something like that. That corner there, by the way, so many people on that day crashed into that corner. Surprised more people didn't break their car. Misjudging quite a few things here, as I said, nerves again. Lever coming up to the end of the race now. A couple more laps and you will see a big event that happened at the end of the race. That was quite unfortunate. I'm not sure what happened here, by the way.
Where's he going?
I don't know if there was connection issues or I just zoned out and forgot to steer. Very odd. I'm not fully sure what happened. So in the next lap, I collide with the race leaders. This is the lap I'm talking about. So I really tried to put the throttle on, thinking, oh, it's near the end of the race. I should really push it. Got to the end of the straight, had a collision, and it just kept going wrong for the next two turns. Bit of an unfortunate end for the race. But I ended up in fifth, started in fourth. Here's the collision.
Get over there. Where have you gone?
Getting messed up in there. Feel bad for them because I've just ruined their race. And then I got in their way again. And then this happens as well. They hit me.
Oh my god, what a finish.
Very tricky end to the race.
You are literally getting your ass handed to you. What the shit? You're going the wrong way.
Yeah, very rough way to end the race. But overall it was fun. I thought I drove alright. So I think the biggest change I made was getting those new front tyres on there. They were the Fusion Slim tyres. They gave so much more steering. But to counteract that, I had to turn the dual rate down to 85%. And as you can see here on the setup sheet, I moved out the shocks on the arms at the rear. And then moved them in to the middle hole on the shock tower in the rear. And same thing for the front. And on the arm in the front, I actually moved it out as well. Because it was originally on the inside. Then I also moved the electronics and the battery back to try to give a bit more grip in the rear and to take a bit of the edge away from the front, which definitely helped. What I'm going to hopefully do to remove even more of that really quick reaction is either stiffen up the front end with a roll bar, or let me correct, a stiffer roll bar, because I already put one in that day to try and reduce the steering a bit. And then I'm also going to be trying to add a bit of toe in and then maybe play with the Ackerman, try and get the same steering input, but it be smoother and more stable. And I think, yeah, that's about it for the changes I made on the day. Might be some other stuff. You can always take a look at the setup sheet because it's here on the screen right now. And I'm hoping for the next video, as you can see now, I am going to be giving a little bit of a review if I can. As you all know, after seeing the footage, I'm still not the best driver, but hopefully I'm going to give a little bit of a review on the new Schumacher Azami wheels. I think that's how you say them. I don't know. But yeah, I'm going to give a bit of a review because I think they're really interesting, and if they can reduce my problems with traction rolling I had throughout the day, I think pairing them with some splinter front wheels, which are slightly less edgy than the Fusion Slims, I should be able to get a really, really nice result. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'm hoping to make another video about round 3 of the Winter Series coming up. I'll hopefully be a better driver and get a better result. But yeah, I'll keep uploading. Hope you enjoyed it. See you in the next video.